In today's video, we are going to talk about the Babinski sign or the Babinski reflex. It is one of the pathological reflexes and has been called the most important sign in clinical neurology. It is most significant indication of the disease of a corticospinal tract system. Babinski described two components of the abnormal plantar reflex. He first described toe extension in 1896, and later on in 1903, he described about the fanning of toes. Now let us talk about the position and procedure. The patient should be relaxed and forewarned of the potential discomfort. The knee must be extended, and the best position is usually a supine position. To perform the Babinski sign, it is usually done by stimulating the plantar surface of the foot with a blunt object such as applicator stick, handle of the hammer, the reflex hammer, the tip of a key, and the strength of the stimulus is an important variable. The stimulus should be firm enough to elicit a consistent response, but as light as that will suffice to elicit a response. So the procedure begins with the stimulation near the heel of the foot, carried up to the side of the foot, and usually stopped at the metatarsophalangeal joint. Now let us see this on a patient. So we begin a stimulation near the sole of the foot, stroke the plantar side of the foot up to the first metatarsophalangeal joint. The response has usually occurred by the time the stimulus reaches the mid portion of the foot. If the response is difficult to obtain, the stimulus should be continued along the metatarsal pad from the little toe medially, but stopping short of the base of great toe. The response may sometimes be reinforced by rotating the patient's head to the opposite side. So in a normal individual, stimulation of the skin of the plantar surface of foot is followed by a plantar flexion of the great toe. The response is usually fairly rapid, and the small toe flex more than the great toe. So as we can see in this patient, the normal response is plantar flexion of the toes. Let us now talk about the Babinski sign or extensor plantar response. This may be a slow tonic or sometime clonic dorsiflexion of the great toe and the small toes with fanning or separation of the toes. This is seen in the diseases of the corticospinal tract, and hence it's a reliable upper motor neuron sign. The slow great toe movement has also been described as a majestic rise. So in a patient of corticospinal tract disease, Babinski sign is being characterized by dorsiflexion of the great toe with fanning or separation of the small toes. The movement of great toe can be very well seen in this patient. What is triple flexion response? In severe extensive disease of the corticospinal tract, stimulation of the sole causes three responses, that is dorsiflexion of the toe and ankle, flexion at the hip joint, and flexion of the knee joint. All these together is known as triple flexion response. You can see in this patient that there is a dorsiflexion of the toe and ankle, as well as flexion at the knee joint and hip joint. The findings may not be that straightforward in all the patients. So the point to remember is we have to focus on the initial movement of the great toe. In voluntary withdrawal, there is usually plantar flexion of the toes, and it occurs when the stimulus is too intense or uncomfortable. Now what is mute or silent plantar? Some of the patients have no elicitable plantar response, in which case there is no movement of the great toe or smaller toes, and hence the plantar is said to be mute or silent. Sometimes we might also just observe asymmetry of the plantar response on two sides. This might also be significant. A toe that does not go down as crisply as its fellow may be a suspect, even if it does not frankly go up. In the first patient, what do you think of the plantar response? Firstly, there is an inversion at the ankle joint. There is adduction and flexion of the smaller toes, but the great toe shows extension. Hence, our plantar response is said to be an extensor response. In the second patient, observe the response to stimulus. There is no movement in the great toe or any other toes. Hence, the plantar is said to be mute. An extensor plantar response is taken to be normal till infancy. The maturation of the descending motor systems suppresses the primitive flexion response, and this may be necessary for normal ambulation. The corticospinal tract is myelinated by about the end of first year of life, and it corresponds to the time when babies begin to walk. By the time, the plantar reflex becomes a flexor response. In severe corticospinal tract diseases, threshold for eliciting an upgoing toe is lower, and the reflexogenic zone widens. This has led to alternate methods for eliciting Babinski response. Chaddock's sign. Here we stimulate the lateral aspect of the foot and not the sole. The stimulus starts under the lateral malleolus near the junction of the dorsal and plantar skin. Draw the stimulus from the heel forward to the small toe, and this produces less withdrawal than the plantar stimulation. Oppenheim sign. This is being elicited by dragging the knuckles heavily down the anteromedial surface of the tibia from the infrapatellar region of the ankle. The response is slow and often occurs towards the end of stimulation. The below mentioned two tables also explain about some of the named signs which are being elicited when the reflexogenic zone is increased.